In the previous recording, Yuri introduced herself to the rest of the group and essentially threatened to go after them. Based on what they've seen, it appears that Yuri is quite strong, and there's the weird issue of her possibly being able to control multiple magic, which is something that they are not yet quite sure about. So, in order to defend themselves, they discuss stuff a little bit. He told us a previous about that, and whatever. And the plan that they end up coming up with is, well, so in the house where they are staying, well, usually it's Luna, Misaki, and Mark staying there, but they will all be staying there for a while. And below the house, not directly below the house, but like basically where, like in front, like below the house, but further to the front, there's like this big open area. And well, in front of the house is this big open area, and below this big open area, there's like a big pool of water. There's like an open room, and in this room, there's like a pool that's filled with water, and the room is connected with pipes upwards to the surface. And in the immediate vicinity of the rest of the house, there's no other larger body of water. So, what they do, what they're planning to do is that, so we've seen Yuri apparently demonstrate being able to use wind magic, earth magic, and fire magic. Now, whether that's actually her using all three magic, or whether she's working with other people who are hidden, they conjecture that Yuri will have a way of controlling water as well. So the plan is that as long as able, Luna will constantly be in control of the water, of the body of water, and Misaki and Miu will be scouting for Yuri's approach with the method that they learned, where they take control of like small snippets of air or earth. And I mean, obviously Luna has to sleep occasionally, and so do the others. I mean, Miu and Misaki can work in shifts, but Luna is the only one who can take control of the big body of water. And so basically the idea is that Luna just keeps constant control of this huge body of water, and then when Yuri comes and attacks them, which is what they're anticipating, then Luna will have this big body of water as an as a way, like access to that, and be able to fight with that, which is very, very strong, because Luna is very, very strong. And then if for some reason that doesn't work, like if she attacks while Luna's asleep, or somehow like the pipes get blocked or something, if for whatever reason they aren't able to make use of that big body of water, they will then slowly retreat to the ocean, like the docks thing, which is somewhat close to them, close-ish. And basically the idea, like the way that they would handle the combat is how they would usually do, where so the roof, not the roof, the building next to the roof, like a little bit lower, there's like a little precipice thing. And Leiji would be stationed up there with a sniper rifle, being able to shoot at Yuri, or if Yuri has any companions, at them. Then Luna and Misaki and Yuri on the front lines, with Mark as like sort of like the battlefield tactician, a little bit further to the back. And that's how they would like to be able to fight that. And so they basically set this up. They have Miu and Misaki constantly watching out. Yuri's, not Yuri, Luna is keeping control of the water, and every occasionally she sleeps for like 2 hours and then takes control of the water again. She can't keep control of the water while she's asleep because she has to concentrate on it. And so they do that for a while. And naturally, because things never go well, at some point Luna is asleep. And Miu, while she's doing the thing, the trying to detect her, she notices that she can't take control of the air where she tried, but where she notices this is pretty far into her range already. She has like, I don't know, like really, if she has like, she has like a 1 kilometer range, then I'm not entirely sure if she already has a 1 kilometer range at this point. I don't think she does. Say she has like an 800 meter range, maybe. Right now. Not entirely sure if that's accurate right now. I haven't spent enough time trying to figure out how the ranges worked again. And it's been a long time since I've originally came up with this. Let's say it's 800 meters right now. And Yuri is then maybe already, or not Yuri necessarily. The point where she notices she can't take control is already like 400 meters into her range. So, assuming that Yuri takes control of the air in her immediate surroundings, it means that Yuri has already gotten quite close. And so she immediately alerts the others and wakes up Luna. But by the time Luna is like awake, has understood the situation, and tries to control the water is already being controlled. So they set up in their combat formation. They head out. They wanna like start going towards the other place. And by the time they're outside, Yuri is already within, like with on this free open area. And so they can't just easily turn their back and run away because they will be attacked from behind, so they have to basically do a fighting retreat. And so Leiji is up on the precipice on the rooftop, next to the rooftop, firing. But just like Miu has practiced with Leiji, Yuri just diverts the attacks. And Misaki and Luna on the ground. Luna just with her normal, like, couple liters of water. Mark's a little bit further back. And Misaki is basically making like earth shields for the three of the frontliners. And as soon as Deiji gets the second shot off and misses, Yuri sends a wind blade over to Deiji, and Deiji has to drop the gun and take out his rapier and start concentrating on this. Neo is also a little bit further back because he has the bigger range. And Mew deploys her two wind blades. So first off, she deploys a wind blade over to Deji to help him with that. But Deji quickly tells her that she should focus on Yuri. So she's doing this. So she has her wind blades and she's like attacking Yuri with it, but Yuri promptly matches her wind blades and defends against them with her own. And so they're trying to like move steadily back, mostly fighting defense. And what Yuri's doing is she's basically like creating, so she's taking rocks from the ground. She has not done anything with the water as far as people can see. But he's taking out like smaller sized rocks from the ground and moves them, like she basically throw them with like the magic controlling towards the shields that Miu has, not Miu, Misaki has raised up. And on impact, the rocks explode. And that makes like a lot of damage, puts a lot of damage into the shields, and the shields like immediately crack. And Yuri is firing these exploding rocks a lot faster than me, but me, Misaki can pull up the shields. So what ends up happening, what Misaki ends up having to do to protect the others is throw and take her own rocks and basically intercept Yuri's rocks. And the problem with that is that every time rocks explode, like a little bit of shrapnel spreads around. And something that E Luna is doing here. So we know that Yuri can control wind magic. So we are presuming that she can control wind blades. And wind blades are somewhere, well, not wind blades necessarily, but just wind movement in general is somewhere between very hard and impossible to see. So we have like these wind glasses thing that allow us to see wind. And all the others beside Luna have them on. But what Luna is actually doing is that she has three very thin, like very, very, very thin, half spheres of water around her, basically. So like an inner sphere that's like a little bit like, I don't know, 30 centimeters away from her. And then 50 centimeters out from that is another sphere, and 50 centimeters from that is another sphere. And she uses those spheres to tell the movement of the wind blades and just the wind in general that Yuri is controlling. Although Yuri right now is only, the only focus with her wind blades is on defending against Miu's wind blades and the one against the DG. He just currently coming down. So Luna is just kind of like, so Miu is just like trying to fight with the wind blades while generally like moving wind in good ways, like moving wind to misdirect the shrapnel from the exploding things. It's like make it harder for Yuri to move and stuff like that. Just like general support. Luna is fighting with just her water, but it's mostly being blocked off by Yuri's earth magic. And she's like using the layers to defend against the shrapnel. So she can like basically she can like before she can see where the shrapnel is going, she can feel that the shrapnel intersects the water sphere thing. And she can protect against it that way. But it's not with how fast she's throwing these exploding rocks, and with how like scattered the shrapnel is, people aren't perfectly protecting against it. So there's like they get like small scratches and stuff like sometimes. So this goes on for a while. They're moving backwards. Viji goes down from the rooftop while fighting the thing. Moving backwards, they keep like, getting closer and closer to the water, like to the docks thing. They're not really making a lot of headway. I mean, not. What I mean is, they are getting back, but they're not hitting Yuri with anything or something. On the other hand, they're also not significantly getting hit. As I said, sometimes just like small scratches and stuff, but nothing really bad happens. And at some point, this keeps going for a while, but they're going back and they reach a dock at some point where the big body of water is. And they make like a faster, like once they're close, they make like a dash for it so that Luna can start taking control of the water. And that's when they go more on the offensive. So Lady starts providing cover fire again. She isn't gonna hit, but it's gonna take her attention away. Well, really she has to put ways up to defend it, either with wind or with earth. And Luna just takes control of like massive amounts of water, just like small buildings like full of water, and basically just smashes it against Yuri. Yuri's doing against this is basically she's continuously throwing up earth barriers as she's walking. So she's like, say the water's coming from like somewhere in front of her, like front right maybe, whatever. And she makes like a wall of earth and then throws up another wall of earth directly immediately after, and then the wall crumbles as like the water hits it. And then she makes another wall, and then this crumbles, and then basically it like keeps going like that, and the water keeps like eroding away at the walls while she's forming them. All the while she's defending with her own earth protections against Misaki's earth attacks. What's worth noting, I should have probably mentioned this before. But both Misaki and Yuri are doing is that the earth immediately, so for Yuri, the earth immediately around her, within like a couple of meters, is constantly in Yuri's control. And then the earth, like, immediately around Misaki and the rest of the team is constantly in Misaki's control, so that they can't just, like, make earth attacks from immediately in front of them. But they're doing this. So there's like the big torrents of water coming down on her while she's blocking against the earth attacks. Mark's not really doing much of anything other than like coordinating. Well, he's coordinating. It's valuable. And as it seems, Yuri's water attack is actually eroding the walls faster than. No, Luna's water attacks is eroding Yuri's stone walls faster than she is able to recreate them. Although it's not quite clear if that's because she can't like throw up walls that fast, or because I mean, for her to create a wall, she has to like use the rock that's there, and she has to get the wall out of the ground. And if she's only walking so fast or running so fast, then she can only throw up so many walls while she's going in that direction, basically. The walls are eroding faster than she can throw them up. So what Yuri is doing now, there's like huge, huge masses of water, and Luna can't take control of all of that. So now, I mean, I've basically given it away at this point that Yuri is indeed controlling all the things. So Yuri starts taking control of water, and she crashes it against Luna's torrents of water, but instead of just like it's different. It's, the way it works is different. So Luna just has like these big bodies of water, and she just crashes them down. Just this is like just this continuous stream. Luna takes like also these bodies of water, but they're like formed in basically that like like also a stream, but in the stream there's like holes. There's like empty space with no water in it. And every time the these empty spaces crash against or crash against Luna's water, there's like these it has this weird crashing effect where it's not quite sure what's happening, but they come together and there's it's not like an explosion, but it's like it crashes together and it like spreads, it like splatters out. And with that, Yuri is greatly dispersing the effect of Luna's attack. And up until this point, Yuri had basically been walking towards the direction of Luna, and now she starts dashing. And Miu and Misaki immediately try their best to slow them down, to slow her down. When Yuri, out of Yuri's sleeve, falls like a small, like maybe 2 or 3 centimeter diameter sphere, and it shoots towards Luna's direction. And so Miu is trying to misdirect it with wind, and it has like no effect at all. It's just like she's pushing wind against it to misdirect it, and it's not budging at all. And Misaki tries to like stone walls into its way, and those do slow it down, but it's not, they're not stopping it, and they're not breaking it, they're not stopping it, it's like breaking through, it's only slowing it down. But it's moving fairly slowly, and so it moves towards Luna, but Luna can dodge it. And but while she's dodging it, she's still doing this whole water torrent, but Yuri starts spending more resources on directly attacking Luna, and so she has this weird small sphere thing going after her that she constantly has to dodge, and she's now throwing those water things, not only in the appalling water, but also directly at Luna. And she's now spending very little. Like she's only previously she had like been blocking attacks from, say, Misaki, for example, by like putting up stone walls. And now what she's doing is that she's just using very small or like semi-small stone pellets, and intercepting them. And then the rest of the resources, she's like, she puts like huge like pillars of stone and like spikes, directly attacking Luna. And she's not your against all the others, she's only defending. And Luna, she's attacking very directly. And Luna keeps like dodging, and the others keep supporting her. Until at some point, she has a rock flying. So she got closer because she's running, and that extends her range. And then at some point, she gets her range behind Luna and behind the area that Misaki is protecting around Luna. And she has from multiple positions behind her, a bunch of rocks flying her way as Luna is currently trying to dodge the sphere thing, and they hit her in the back of the head, and Luna falls over. And now Liddy abandons his sniping distraction thing, takes out his rapier, and runs to water. Mio was also getting closer, and Yuri starts, like, she basically, so she was focusing on Luna, and now she's like paying attention to the other people again. And so Mark was staying back, and Mark is also starting to go closer because Mark is really mad about what just happened to Luna. Mark puts a lot of value in his friends, a lot of emotional value, and he's like really mad about this. So he's stepping a bit closer. And Luna, so that's like at this point, if you imagine like, okay, we imagine just some flat space, and Miu, not Miu, Yuri is, let's say, in the bottom left. Then Misaki is like, maybe 50 meters away from her upwards. Luna is on the ground 30 meters away from her, 60 meters away from her to the right. Miu is like right between, well, between Luna, who's now on the ground, and Misaki, but a little bit further distance to Yuri. Then, like 30 meters behind Miu is the Deji, closing the distance. And then further up from the Deji is Mark. So you're just coming up closer. And now Yuri is focusing her attacks on Mark. Mark's in her range of her wind attacks, and with the shield around, like with the earth that's being controlled around Mark by Misaki, she doesn't have range behind Mark, but she can still just fling stuff his way. And Mark doesn't have a good way of defending himself. So Yuri's focusing her attacks on Mark. And now that means that Misaki has to spend all her attention trying to defend Mark. And as they're coming closer, Miu is still like battling with her wind blades and her winds, but she's also coming closer, she's trying to go into close quarters. But before long, Misaki's sole defense of Mark just doesn't work, and first he gets like a bunch of scratches and like some some deeper wounds until at some point Mark II gets hit in the head by a rock and falls down. So now Misaki is really mad. And Misaki starts being more less orderly in her attacks. Like Misaki is very a very by the book person. But now he's like more chaotically trying to attack her. Attack Yuri. Which then leads to her missing missing it as the sphere thing approaches her, and Miu tries to divert it, but it doesn't work. And by the time that Misaki is able to react to it, she also gets hit in the head. So now Misaki is down, and just Miu and Reiji are left. Reiji and so, yes. So Reiji catches up to Miu, and they're both starting to engage her in close quarters. Reiji with the rapier, and Miu just without arms, without being armed. And so, as they did with sparring, Miu keeps like basically adding wind to her attack, so that basically just they're trying to beat her down now in close quarters. And Yuri at this point has completely stopped using the water, and Yuri is also not using the weird sphere thing anymore. All she's doing now is she is similar to Miu, like adding to her movement with the wind, as well as from the ground making like these stone pillars that come to attack the other two. As I've explained in the magic explanation video, she can't easily, like, you can't just like put one below a person. Like you can't just like control a spike, control earth below a person and make a spike come out. Because even if this magic user isn't, or if this person isn't a magic user, you still have control of your very immediate surroundings. So she has to first take control away from, let's say, Reiji, and Reiji feels that, so he has the time to dodge. And so Yuri has like does like a mixture of taking control of the earth a little bit further away and using that to make pillars, or just like accepting that Reiji will realize this and have time to dodge. Same with Miu. But despite working together, they do not manage to land a hit, as Yuri is continuously able to block their attacks and strike back at them. And Yuri is not doing much damage. He's not hitting them with the earth attacks and the like kicks and hits she gets off of them are solid, but they're not able to bring them down for a while at least, until eventually Reiji, no, not Reiji, Miu gets put into a situation where she has to dodge a spike and a kick, and is thus not able to dodge an incoming pillar that hits her in the head and Miu's down. And now it's just Reiji left, but without Miu's support, he quickly also gets hit by another pillar, and Reiji goes unconscious. And that's it for this.